Jesus. I don't know what Jesus.
The greatest example of generosity this world of greed has ever seen. And when Jesus hit the scene, he changed the scenery and met the person with serenity. If you're looking for peace, he offers plenty. Jesus was and Jesus will forever be king. And when the angels dreamed that scene of the grace that was displayed for sinners like me, I can't explain him and I can't describe him. And if I could, he wouldn't be Jesus. Because you can't explain eternity and you can't comprehend the galaxies, but it was the loving hands of Jesus who spun them into existence and created man, knowing he would go to the cross to pay our sentence. There was a certificate of judgment with a period after the sentence. And we were sentenced to death long before he said it is finished. He is a father, an orphan, a shelter for the homeless, a hiding place for the abused, and an anchor for our storms. He stormed the gates of hell and came out on top, and the power of his gospel cannot be stopped. Even when the world tries, they try a lot. He traded places with Barabbas and became the catalyst of missions across the world, covering every portion of the Atlas. If you're in need of rest, I know of a mattress. If you don't know Jesus, your future is tragic, but he gladly embraced tragedy so we could live in his presence of magic. His presence is presence, and it's his presence that presents preciousness to a world of peasants. He is far from pretentious, but still loves those who are. He is alive, the world, and hung the stars. He brings the dead to life and delivers life to the dead. He took a crown of thorns on his head so we could put crowns at his feet, and I can't wait until I get to kiss his feet that were nailed to the cross for me and for you and for every person around the world. He loves the world, and I love his word, because the word became flesh, and in his flesh he demonstrated the word to the world. He is an example to every boy and every girl. He is a lover of black people. He is a lover of white people. He is a lover of the unchurched and the assembly under the steeple. He doesn't see the believers' failures, but still takes time to celebrate their faithfulness. It's the power of the Spirit that enables us and gives us boldness when the world labels us. And if you want to label me, please call me a Jesus freak. That freaks you out good. Because it's better to be good with God than to fight being misunderstood by a world that could never understand. So let it be understood that I don't worship man.